Tesca Technologies Private Limited. I am Shivam Vijay. Today in this video, I am going to describe and demonstrate about the triggering circuit for SCR trainer. In this trainer, we will find out the different ways to triggering the SCR, the silicon controlled rectifier. The silicon controlled rectifier is basically a three terminal and two PN junction device and a semiconductor device, which is generally used for different types of converting AC to DC rectifications. So now we are going to see different methods of triggering SCR. So this is our trainer board. In this trainer board, there is a basic schematic diagram printed on the onboard circuit, and this is the triggering circuit for SCR trainer board. The order code for this trainer kit is 46543. You can use this order code to check the specification and to purchase the kit by visiting our website, which is www.tescaglobal.com. So this is the complete setup in which different parts are provided. I will explain all the parts and all the circuitry different one by one. And this is the user manual in which all the experiments which are from triggering the SCR from R, which is the resistance. Then we will trigger the SCR with the R and C in coupling resistance and capacitance. Then we see the UJT firing circuit. All the details about the different type of practicals are given in this user manual. We will refer this user manual, follow the procedure and do the practicals with this trainer board. The accessories, patch cords for the connections are also provided with this trainer board. So now we are going to see the circuit description of the trainer board. Then you will follow the practicals accordingly. So in this circuit, we have the 18 volt AC supply provided on bridge of two diodes, by which we can convert this AC to the DC supply. And this is a 18 volt AC 100 milliampere AC power supply, and also 9 volt DC at 100 milliampere Zener regulated power supply. The Zener diode circuit for UJT firing is over here provided. So this knob is used for controlling the UJT firing circuit of the firing angle and the firing different types of firing range. And this is the SCR firing using 1 mega ohm potentiometer, direct potentiometer firing for the resistance and RC circuit. So we will use this firing circuit for resistance and RC circuit for the purpose of firing, and other one for UJT firing. These are the two types of firing in this triggering circuit trainer we will understand. And these are the load components for provided. These are the two knobs in which 1 kilo ohm resistance of 1 watt power supply is provided in series with a 1 kilo ohm potentiometer. So we can vary the complete resistive load from 1 kilos to 2 kilo ohm by using this potentiometer. Similarly, there is another load in series for 1 kilo ohm with 1 watt resistance and also a 5 kilo ohm potentiometer, so that the complete load can be used on these terminals are 6 kilo ohm up to, or complete load which will be 6 and 2 is equals to 8 kilo ohm for the load purpose. So we can connect both the resistive loads in series also. This is an SCR 2N665 compatible, which have three terminals, anode, cathode and gate. So we require to fire the gate pulse for the conducting of SCR. So we will first provide SCR, which is an inbuilt SCR in this RC circuit also. So we will provide the supply to gate pulse first using the resistance only, then we provide supply for using the capacitor and the diode or the resistance also. So we will see both the circuits using the SCR firing. Then we see half wave and full wave controlled rectifier using the UJT firing circuit. Also observe the UJT firing with this UJT firing circuit on different points. So first of all, we will do the object one, which is resistor triggering circuit for SCR. In this, we will follow the procedure, design up the circuit diagram by connecting patch cords on this supply. So this section is separate from the supplies. So we have to provide supply on the circuit, then we connect all the different types of components on this. By SCR firing knob, we will try to find out the SCR firing pulses, and then we see output on the oscilloscope. So we are using a DSO here for checking the different waveforms on the circuit. So we are now going to build up the circuit accordingly given in the user manual. For this we have to connect the supply first on the cathode of SCR and the other 18 volt supply will be connected on 1 amp potentiometer. Also the anode of SCR will be connected with the load terminal, and the other end of this load will be connected across the SCR. So this is our circuit diagram here. Now we will turn on the supply and check the connections, and the output will be observed on the CRO. After doing the connections, we will observe the waveform across the SCR first, then we observe waveform across the load. For observing the waveform across SCR, we will connect the negative of CRO probe to the cathode and the positive will be pointed towards SCR firing. So you can see the slight variation in the SCR firing circuit as I increase the resistance in between them. Now complete firing should be achieved first, then we will observe the output waveform on the 1 kilowatt potentiometer as a load. Similar waveform is achieved. Now as we vary the 1 kilo ohm potentiometer, you will see the waveform is, and the amplitude of this waveform is decreasing across the load. So you can see our SCR has been fired through the SCR firing, and we can control the SCR with this potentiometer and also the SCR firing potentiometer. Also you can observe the amplitude is decreasing when I decreasing the value of 1 kilo ohm potentiometer on the CRO as well. Here you can see the channel 1 peak to peak voltage is 12 volt. Now as I decrease the value, the peak to peak value is also decreasing up to 9 volts. So this is our first experiment. Now we move on to the second experiment. Now for second experiment, we will do the triggering of SCR using resistor and capacitor. The RC triggering circuit is been implemented for this circuit diagram. So this is the circuit diagram and connection given in the user manual. So we have to follow and build up the circuit diagram as described in this. Then we follow the procedure as explained in the user manual to find out the different various waveform and to see the triggering using resistor and capacitor of SCR. So we are building up the circuit as described in the user manual. For this we have to connect the 18 volt supply on this capacitor. Then the dotted line should be completed accordingly as described. So we have added the SCR firing circuit to the SCR. Now we will connect the load across the SCR. So we will connect the load 1K potentiometer and 1 kilowatt resistance in series across the SCR like this. So we have completed our circuit diagram according to the user manual. Now we will power on the circuit and see the SCR firing and observe the waveforms across the SCR and load as well. So now we are going to connect the SCR probes negative on the cathode of the SCR and positive on the anode of the SCR and turn on the circuit. Here you can observe the output waveforms according to the SCR firing circuit on the DSO. So as I slightly increasing the potentiometer value, the SCR pulses or the SCR waveform output is decreasing and variation provides accordingly. As I completely increase the potentiometer, the SCR is completely in turned off position, and now I am increasing the value, sorry, decreasing the value, so SCR is in firing mode. So SCR has been fired. Now we will observe the waveforms across the load. For this, connect the CRO across the load terminals. Here the peak to peak value also on the waveform is 3.74 volts for this case, and now as I increasing the value of 1 kilo ohm potentiometer, the SCR value peak is also increasing accordingly. So that's how we vary and control the potentiometer to control the SCR powers. And for the load increasing purpose, you can increase the load by connecting R1 and R2 loads in series, so you will get the value on the SCR, and you can also observe the better variation by moving both the ports accordingly. So that's how we perform the SCR triggering circuit, which are the basic electrical circuit to firing the SCR with the resistor and then resistor capacitor also. Now we will see the SCR firing using unijunction transistor circuit, which is also known as relaxation oscillator circuit. The third experiment is to check the unijunction transistor UJT triggering circuit, or also known as UJT relaxation oscillator. The procedure is as follows, described in the user manual, and this is the circuit diagram of the UJT triggering circuit. By this circuit we can observe the different gate pulses, and the pulse transformer is provided to isolate the output pulses from the actual circuit of the firing. So this is the complete setup, and these are the waveform outputs that can be observed on the output terminals. So we will connect these wires to the, or provide the supply to the UJT firing circuit, then we observe the output at different points as described in the user manual. Now we will provide DC supply to the firing circuit. For this, connect this terminal to the A point of this circuit and the bridge terminal of the second diode to be connected on the ground. So we have to provide the supply to this firing circuit, then we check the firing angle control with this potentiometer. Now I am going to connect the CRO probe on the ground. So we have to connect the oscilloscope at point B and E with respect to point A, and we will observe the waveform with different points. So here, as I on the circuit and check the waveform of point A, so this is the waveform at point A. We can see now waveform at point B as I am connecting the CRO probe on point B. So these are the waveform on point B. Now we will check the waveforms on point E. So this is the waveform on point E. Increase the firing angle, you will get the proper waveform in a ramp type waveform for firing of UJT oscillation circuits. And similarly at B, we can observe the waveform changes according to the firing circuit, and at A. So these are the different waveforms. Also given in the user manual, you can observe all the waveform and match the waveforms at different points. Given in the figure mentioned in the user manual. So these are the waveform that we are achieving, which is VA, similarly as we have seen in the DSO, and VB is slightly clipped from the upper end as described in the user manual, and at VE we are getting the triangular shape like waveform on the output. Now we will observe the waveform across the gate pulses on the pulse transformer. For this we have to connect the negative on the cathode or the K point of the pulse transformer and check this at G point. Here you can see slight pulses on the screen of the DSO. Here you can see these are the simple pulses. These pulses have voltage peak of 4.6 volt. Now as I increasing the firing angle, the pulses voltage peaks are also increased here up to 5 volts, and I am decreasing the voltage, so this is going to lower. So that's how the pulse UJT firing circuit works. Different pulses, you can see the pulse in the extreme broad condition. Now firing of the pulses can increase and decrease the gate pulse or the firing angle of the SCRs like this. This is working on the single pulse. Here you can see pulse can be varied according to the firing circuit or firing angle control. So this was the third practical in which we have seen the UJT firing circuit. This firing circuit can be applied to fire the SCR for any of the half wave control rectifier or full wave control rectifier. So both the circuits will be also seen in this practical. Fourth practical, we will see the half wave control rectifier. For this we will using this circuit described in the user manual, and also we will apply the SCR which is extra provided on this circuit. So we are now going to build the circuit accordingly as per the user manual, then we follow the procedure and see the half wave control rectifier. Now for next practical, we will check the half wave rectifier or control rectifier using UJT firing circuit on a SCR. So the circuit diagram is given in this user manual. We will build up the connection as per the description in this user manual, then we follow the procedure and see the output waveforms of half wave control rectifier on the SCR with this complete circuitry and this trainer board. So now we are going to build up the connections as per the circuit diagram. For that we have to connect this terminal to the load of 5 kilo ohms. For this we can use the 5 kilo ohm potentiometer, and similar end will also connected to powering the SCR circuit as well, sorry, firing circuit as well. And as we are working with the half wave control rectifier, so we will include only two diodes here. So these diodes will be connected on the cathode of SCR. So we are using this SCR which is separately given to provide the half wave rectifier actions, and gate pulses will be given from this SCR firing circuit. The cathode will be common using this pulse transformer cathode and original cathode of the SCR. Now we will have to connect the anode of SCR to the other end of this load circuit. So that's how our circuit diagram has been completed. Now we will Also, we have to also provide the ground terminal to the ground terminal or negative of the SCR firing controller. Now we will check the waveforms across the load. That should be a half wave control rectifier waveform, and we will observe the output on the SCR across also. Now we will observe the output waveform of half wave control rectifier. For that, connect the CRO probes negative and positive across the cathode and anode of the SCR and turn on the circuit. Here you can see the waveform output is of the half wave, and now as I turning the firing angle, you can see the simple distortions or the gate pulse like slide pulses or spikes on the waveforms are moving slightly. Here you can observe the waveform pulses which are moving on the SCR. So that can be concluded the firing circuit is completely working, but for the more controlling with this, we need to add some comparator and different types of circuits in the local industrial purposes. This is a basic circuit at which we can see the half wave converted and controlled waveform approx is this. We can also observe the firing angle control on the E terminal as well. Like this, the waveform changes the firing angle. On the output waveform, this is the waveform across the E terminal of the UJT firing circuit with the firing angle controller. Now we will observe the output waveform on the load. For this, we need to connect the positive terminal to the 5 kilo ohm potentiometer terminal. Here you can see the output waveform is approximately sine wave, which have the negative cycle of the AC power supply is clipped, and we have a half wave control rectifier output on the output terminal. So output waveform is, that's how we control the half wave rectifier on the load. Now for the last one, we will see the full wave control rectifier using the UJT firing circuit given in the strainer board, and we will build up the circuit diagram as described in the user manual and follow the practical and see the different waveforms which have been fully controlled rectifier form. So this is the circuit. We have to provide the load supply across the full wave converted DC supply, and then we add the firing circuit to provide gate pulses using this firing circuit. So we are going to build up the circuit connections on the trainer board. For this, connect this terminal, common cathode terminals of diode D1 and D3 to the 1 kilo ohm resistance. Similarly, we will connect the other end of this 1 kilo ohm resistance to the anode of SCR. Now the cathode of SCR will be connected to the common anode terminal of D2 and D4. Now for gate pulses, we will connect cathode to cathode and pulse transformer gate supply to the G terminal of this SCR. Now for providing the power supply, you can provide the power supply to UJT circuit using this power supply terminals. Providing power supply to UJT firing circuit, for this connect the DC supply directly to the firing circuit A terminal and ground terminal. Now we will turn on the circuit trainer board by using this power on off button. Now we will observe the outputs across the SCR. This should be full wave control rectifier output waveform. So we'll connect the CRO probes across the SCR, cathode and anode. Now as we connect the SCR oscilloscope at the SCR, we will see similar waveform, but this is the negative and positive both cycles are in the rectification form, and the gate pulses as described in the half wave control rectifier, the slight gate pulses due to the gate pulses or triggering spikes are showing, which is moving also on the waveforms. So that's how the firing angle is controlled. Now we will see the waveforms across the load. So the load waveform is completely full wave rectified. In the last waveform or the half wave rectifier, we have seen the half wave is clipped due to the half wave rectifier control actions. As we have applied all the four diodes in this circuit, so positive and negative half both are in the waveform output as described. So this is the full wave control rectifier. Firing angle and different movements can be controlled accordingly. Now according to the SCR, we can also observe the firing angle control on the point E. Now connect the positive probe of the CRO on point E of the UJT firing circuit, and you can observe the output waveform firing angles on the UJT firing circuit like this. So firing angle is controlling it, but due to the lack of different types of comparator and different circuits, filter and different circuits, you can observe the slight variation across the SCR. But for proper achievement of this SCR triggering or controlling of the firing can be achieved by any of the load waveform by using different types of circuitry. So that's how we perform all the experiments on this trainer board. You also perform all types of experiments given in the user manual and also study the firing circuits, different type of firing circuits. We have performed R circuit firing with the resistance and also RC circuit firing with the resistance and capacitance, and also by UJT firing circuit. We have studied also the UJT firing circuit and how the UJT firing circuits work with the SCR. So that's how we do all the practicals with this trainer board. You can use the user or refer to the user manual for detailed study about this. And while working with this kit, if you find any difficulties, you can contact to Test Cutting Logistics Private Limited for all types of supports. Thank you.